Bart's back again. This time we are gonna go through, everybody knows This Is Nowhere, which is the first album with Crazy Horse.
Right. This is his second release with his name. First with Crazy Horse, as you said. And following the self-titled album that we talked about in episode one.
And there is a quote in it from the last track called Cowgirl in the Sand. In the lyrics.
Right.
Hello, cowgirl in the sand. Is this place at your command? Can I stay here for a while? Can I see your sweet, sweet smile? Old enough how to change your name? When so many love you, is it the same?
Is
it the woman in you that makes you want to play this game?
Right. So that's
the chorus.
Cowgirl in the Sand. So who the heck was Crazy Horse? And by the way, this is the record.
There's a dog in here.
Right.
And on the cover.
Right. We never found out who the dog is. We meant to look that up. This is on the single, the Tan Reprise label. I got to get the two-tone. That's for you record people. But in any case, who was Crazy Horse, right? So, I'll show you guys
The Rockets, which is a band before Crazy Horse.
And the three main members from The Rockets are...
Bobby Natkoff.
Well, no, Bobby Natkoff plays violin on one track on this, actually. But the three main members of The Rockets who came on to be in Crazy Horse
Danny Witten, Billy Talbot, and Ralph Molina.
Billy Talbot. Yeah, Danny Witten on guitar, Billy Talbot on bass, Ralph Molina on drums. So, I think the story goes that Neil Young saw the Rockets playing somewhere and was really into them. And apparently, no one else really thought these guys were, like, all that good. And he liked them for their sort of the feel and their scrappiness and sort of their vibe. They weren't necessarily technically gifted per se.
And then after that, in 1969, they did an album called Everybody Knows This Is Nowhere.
Right. So in any case, what about the songs on this album? What about the songs? So Cinnamon Girl, I think, is one of the greatest rock songs ever. What do you think?
It is a really good song. What do you think, Camera Woman?
Classic.
I think it's got one of the best riffs, really. It's just such a great guitar riff that really perfectly kicks off the album.
What's funny about it is there's two tracks long, Down by the River, which is the last track on the first side, and Cowgirl in the Sand, which is the last track. And what I think is interesting, he ended both sides with, well, Down by the River for 9 minutes and Cowgirl in the Sand for 10.
That is interesting, yeah. Well, one thing that stands out to me about this album is the first album, the self-titled album, was sort of very, not slick, but, you know, he really worked really hard on the arrangements with Jack Nitzsche, like trying to get as much complex dynamics going on as possible.
And if you'd like to know,
he was very careful with his vocals and everything like that. And on this album, it feels very loose and raw and sort of quickly done, which is why I love it.
If you'd like to know about the first album, self-titled, just find the channel on YouTube. It's called Quarantine Hearts, and then look for the other video called Episode 1, Neil Young.
Right, but we're not done talking about this. I got a lot more to say. How about you?
Yep.
All right, so Everybody Knows This Is Nowhere. The song is, we were just reading, was interesting, because I guess Neil Young's vocal was like the very first take he did, sort of, and he meant it as a scratch vocal, which means he didn't intend to keep it, but it ended up being what he used.
He was sick when he did this album, and he wrote 4 songs in one day. Cinnamon Girl, Everybody Knows This Is Nowhere, Down by the River, and Cowgirl in the Sand.
Right. According to Wikipedia, they said he had a fever and wrote those all in one day. I mean, if that's true.
And then the other three tracks are Round and Round, It Won't Be Long, The Losing End, When You're On, and Running Dry, Requiem for the Rockets, which is this.
Requiem for the Rockets, which features Bobby Natkoff on violin.
Which is, he does violin in Running Dry.
Right. Well, yeah, right. He plays violin. And that song, we were just listening. I love the ending to that song. It's got the Natkoff violin and those awesome guitar tones that are just sort of ringing out. and there's very little technical proficiency about it. It's very much about the tone.
And then the losing end, he says, "All right, break's taken."
Right, that little Neil Young snapping there in the middle of the song. Oh, and the other cool thing about this album, and I don't know if it's true, but it's been said that Neil Young invented the one-note solo.
In Down by the River on Cowgirl in the Sand.
Yeah, is that maybe where it began? I don't know, but by any stretch of the imagination, Down by the River, I mean, who else would have done a one-note solo? And he plays that for a good, 30 seconds in that song.
And in Cowgirl in the Sand.
Yeah, yep. What else can we say about this album? It's fantastic. It's one of his best, if not his best, if you ask me. Everybody knows this is Nowhere.
It's only seven tracks.
Yeah, but you got two long tracks.
Right.
So this was on Reprise from 1969. And he wouldn't do another album with Crazy Horse until Zuma, 1975. So that's coming
way
later.
We're going to get to that.
We'll get to that. Yeah, David Briggs produced this, which he, again, would work with for many, many records. And it's fantastic. Any other comments about this album? What do you think?
No, but there's a weird thing on here. It says,
The inner sleeve, yeah.
The inner sleeve. It says, "The biggest bargains on record. The Warner Reprise Lost Leaders."
Yeah, this is their old, what they used to put in all the inner sleeves, sort of as like a... You could write to get a compilation for $2.
And then on the other side, there's just more albums.
Yep, Frank Zappa we have. These are the compilations that you can get.
And it says side one, actually. Yeah. Side two.
These compilations that you see all the time in record stores for very cheap because they made so many of them. But this is kind of a cool thing to see.
But it looks like there's two records where it's only a single. They're showing each side.
All right, so what do you think? Neil Young with Crazy Horse, everybody knows this is Nowhere. How many shakies does it get?
I think
10. I was going to say about 7.
Really?
No, I'm kidding. 10! 10 shakies. I love this album.
How about Camera Woman?
I got to give this 10 shakies, too. It's my favorite.
It's fantastic. Yeah, so
it's perfect.
It's a unanimous 10 shaky album.
After this, we will get to Harvest, which is another 10 shaky album.
You're giving away your rating a little ahead of time, but that's not the next album. The next album, I think, will be
After the Gold Rush. And then we get to Harvest, but we'll see about that tomorrow.
Right. Before we go, let's tell everybody about our radio shows that we do for WRFI Community Radio if they want to listen.
I do a show called 9 Years Radio. You can find it at www.mixcloud.com/8YearsRadio. It's now called 9 Years Radio because I changed it when I turned 9.
Right, and when is it on? Live.
Tomorrow.
What's tomorrow?
Tomorrow?
I'm saying it's on every Sunday at 6 o'clock.
Yes.
Right, and then my show is on right after that at 7 o'clock till 9 o'clock, Searching for a Thread. And you can find, both of our shows are on Mixcloud, but you can tune in live Sundays at 6 and 7 at WRFI.org.
Uh-huh.
All right. So thanks for watching this show, Quarantine Hearts, listening to
Episode
Neil Young.
Episode 2, Everybody Knows This Is Nowhere. Bye.
See ya.